So when you're selecting a share in the game, that's your first start. It's the most important thing when you're trading in the share market game. First, you have to have a view. Do you first of all think the market is going to go up or down over the near term? A couple of options then that we think about. So if I think the market's going to go up, then I need to start thinking about the shares that I want to add to my portfolio. If you think the market's going down, there's really only two choices there. Sit on your hands, don't do anything at the moment, or look to the ETF market. There actually are some ETFs that give you exposure to a downturn in the marketplace. So BEAR is one of the codes you might want to look out for there. But let's start thinking about, we think the market's going to go up. I want to buy a stock low and sell it high. Whenever I start thinking about stocks that I want to hold in my portfolio, I start thinking about things that I know. What stocks do we know in the Australian market? So obviously we all know banks, or at least most of us probably have some money in the bank. So you can start thinking about some of the banks we might want to hold in our portfolio. Where do we shop each and every day? Is it that consumer staples part of our market? We start thinking about Coles and Woolies. They're all companies that we know, we trust, we understand, are often a good place to start investing our money in the share market. And that stands exactly the same way for people trading in the share market game. So first of all, let's think about the sectors we might want to get exposed to. Once you've chosen the sector that most suits your style, we then need to look for the company that is going to suit your profile within that sector. It isn't as simple as just looking at the share price of two different shares to give the opinion of which share is worth the most or least. It's not going to give you an idea of value in those companies themselves. So a quick tip when you're picking a share within a sector, we start to have to think about things called price to earnings ratios. So we know the share price, that's going to be given you in the share market game. But start looking behind the share market game in other areas of the ASX website. Look to the announcements of the companies that we're trading in and the latest dividend or corporate announcements or annual reports or mid-year reports that have come from that company. They'll give you something that's called the earnings per share. So we're going to take the share price and the earnings per share of that company. And we're going to divide the share price by the earnings per share. That will give us what's called the price to earnings ratio. That's really important because within a sector, we can now compare the value of one company to another. One company might be on a 10 times price to earnings ratio versus another company that has an 8 times price to earnings ratio. The one with 10 times is more expensive than the one that is 8 times. And it might be a way for you to look at value of which share you might want to hold in a particular sector. So beyond price to earnings ratio, some of the other things we might want to consider when selecting a company. Number one, start thinking about the management of the company. Is it stable management? Do you have trust in the people that are running the company itself? Outside of the management, we also have to have a look at earnings growth over time. We want to see a company that has consistent and stable returns over time, and hopefully we're seeing that growth in earnings as well. No blips on the radar, so not all of a sudden a company having lots of growth one year and a significant loss the next. We want to see consistent returns. They're going to be companies that the market has more trust in.